we're going to continue with our master budgeting process and prepare a direct labor budget. We've already completed three of Grattan Manufacturing's operating budgets in our previous videos. The sales budget estimated the number of units the company is expected to sell and the sales revenue they will earn. The production budget shows the number of units to produce, not only to meet expected sales, but also to ensure the company has safety stock. And then we have the direct materials budget. It shows not only the amount of direct material units, which in this case is kilograms, which are needed to ensure adequate supplies to meet production and safety stock needs, but also how much those purchases will cost. We're now going to produce the next operating budget in the master budgeting process, the direct labor budget. What is a direct labor budget? This budget determines both the quantity in hours and the cost of all the direct labor hours used in the production process to meet production needs. The production needs, which are determined in the production budget. Next to the sales budget, this budget is the easiest to produce. We're continuing with our example of Grattan Manufacturing to demonstrate the preparation of the direct labor budget. Grattan Manufacturing uses 2 hours of direct labor per component. Each hour of labor is paid out at a rate of $18 per hour. Prepare the direct labor budget for the first 3 months and the quarter. Step one is to determine the direct labor hours required for production. This is the total number of hours of direct labor needed. We start with the number of units to produce, which of course we take from the production budget. We multiply it by the direct labor hours needed per unit produced, which will then determine the total quantity of direct labor hours needed for production. We'll apply this in step two, prepare the direct labor budget using a chart. As always, we start with the title, including the company name, Grattan Manufacturing, then the name of the budget, direct labor budget, and the date for the quarter ended March 31st. We then move on and add the necessary columns. Since we're completing the budget for the months and the quarter, we have one column for the description, 3 columns for the months, and 1 column for the quarter, for a total of 5 columns. The headings are description, each of the months, January, February, and March, and finally the total column, which here is named first quarter. We can now use our formula from step one, units to produce multiplied by the direct labor hours per unit to determine the total required direct labor hours. Applying this to our chart, units to produce is the description in the first row, direct labor hours per unit in the second row, and total required direct labor hours in the third row. We now need to start filling out the chart, starting with the units to produce, which we get from the production budget we already completed. Looking at the last row, we will use January 8,400 units, February 9,200 units, March 9,540 units, and the first quarter 27,140 units, and we'll transfer that information into the first row of our direct labor budget. January 8,400 units, February 9,200 units, March 9,540 units, and the first quarter 27,140 units. The next row is the amount of direct labor hours we need per unit, and we get that information from the question. Each component produced requires 2 hours of direct labor, so we'll use that amount of direct labor hours in our chart in row 2, for every month and the first quarter. They all use the same amount, 2 hours. If we now multiply the units to produce by the direct labor hours per unit, we calculate the total required direct labor hours needed to produce our production needs. For January, 8,400 units multiplied by 2 hours is equal to 16,800 hours. For February, 9,200 units multiplied by 2 hours is equal to 18,400 hours. For March, 9,540 units multiplied by 2 hours is equal to 19,080 hours. And for the first quarter, 27,140 units multiplied by 2 hours is equal to 54,280 hours, which is the total direct labor hours needed in order to meet our production needs for the first quarter. Note that we can also calculate the direct labor hours required for the quarter by adding the hours for each of the months. 16,800 hours plus 18,400 hours plus 19,080 hours is equal to 54,280 hours. This can be used as a check to ensure you calculated the total correctly. We now move on to step three, determine the cost of the direct labor hours we'll use in production. Basically, how much will we pay our direct labor employees? The formula is total required direct labor hours multiplied by the cost per direct labor hour is equal to the total direct labor costs. We can now use this formula in step 4, which is to continue to prepare the direct labor budget chart. We'll fill in the last two rows with cost per direct labor hour and total direct labor costs. If we return to the question, we can see that the cost per direct labor hour is $18 per hour. We can therefore fill that in for every month and the first quarter, $18 per hour. And we can do the multiplication for all of the months and the first quarter. For January, 16,800 hours multiplied by $18 per hour is equal to $302,400. For February, 18,400 hours multiplied by $18 per hour is equal to $331,200. For March, 19,080 hours multiplied by $18 per hour is equal to $343,440. And finally, for the first quarter, 54,280 hours multiplied by $18 per hour is equal to $977,040. We can also do a quick check to ensure that our total direct labor costs are correct by adding the total for each month. $302,400 plus $331,200 plus $343,440 is equal to $977,040. That means that our direct labor budget is perfect. That's it. We have now completed the direct labor budget. This is the fourth operating budget in the master budget process, and it's the second operating budget needed to calculate the cost per unit. All of these budgets, the sales budget, the production budget, the direct materials budget, and the direct labor budget that we just completed, are required parts of the master budgeting process for a manufacturing firm. In our next video, we'll continue to move forward with the next operating budget, the manufacturing overhead budget. And just a quick thank you for continuing to watch my videos.